Hi, I'm Shannon, and I design with code. August 6, 1991 was a big day for the world. Something was created on that day that would lead change for the way we interact with each other, gather information, and spend our free time. August 6, 1991 was the day that World Wide Web inventor Tim Berners-Lee published the first website from a lab in the Swiss Alps. The first website was simple, and it was created as a way to share scientific papers across the world. In 1991, I would have never known that someday I'd be designing for the World Wide Web that Tim invented. In 1991, I was 7 years old, and I had a really cool haircut. I haven't cut my hair since. In 1991, some of you probably weren't even born yet. And what's cool about the fact that you probably weren't even born yet, you grew up with the internet. So when you were 7 years old, you probably could have said, hey, when I grow up, I want to design websites. If I would have said that to my parents when I was 7, they would have been like, website? Like, what does that word even mean? I did grow up wanting to be an artist, though. I love to color. I love coloring books, crayons, drawing, markers, all that sort of stuff. And a lot of kids do. But my love for creating never left me as I grew older. And when I was younger, I also loved the computer. I was fortunate enough to have a dad who loved having the latest technology around, so we always had a computer growing up. I'd use the computer to create art in programs like Paint and KidPix. And I'd use the computer to play games all the time, and they came on these giant things called floppy disks, and it was awesome. Art stuck with me as I got older. In high school, I found a love for colored pencils, and I went through a colorful bird phase that landed me an art scholarship to the local college for fine art. My year as a fine artist, I didn't quite know what I wanted to be when I grew up, I found out. Like, I just didn't know if it was right for me. I mean, I was a fine artist. Like, I was fine. I wasn't going to be the next Picasso or Van Gogh. But I loved art, and I loved to create, but I just didn't see a future for myself as a fine artist. I wanted something where I could maybe use my creative talents to solve problems. I needed more focus. And it turns out there's a name for that, a designer. So I quickly traded in my pencil and paper for a MacBook and a mouse. I switched colleges, and I went from a fine art student to a graphic design student. And I loved it. I knew right away that this was where I belonged. I thought if I could find a career doing this every day, I'd never have to work a day in my life. So I graduated college, and I got a job at an agency. And my job was to design websites. I was a web designer. And that can mean a lot of different things. So I'll explain to you kind of how it worked at the agency. So I'd be provided with a set of wireframes. And these are basically like blueprints for a website, similar to blueprints for a house. They'll decide the overall structure of the website, what should be on the page, and sort of where it'll go. And I would take those wireframes, and I would create designs for them based on a company's brand, fonts, colors, all that sort of stuff. A lot of people just would tell me, like, you're just making it pretty, or you just made it pretty. But design is much more than just making things pretty. It's about creating something that is beautiful and functional. It's a lot more than just colors and fonts. Yes, those are important. But creating a delightful experience for the end user of a website is also part of our job. So basically, after I was given those wireframes, I'd create my designs in Photoshop. So my designs were static, meaning you wouldn't quite be able to interact with them. Buttons would have styles, but you wouldn't be able to click on them. All of that interactivity would come later when that static web design was turned into code, which would be the next step. So when I was finished with my designs in Photoshop, I would hand those files over to a developer to make that website function. And they would take that static file, and they would turn it into a working website. And they basically were translating that design into code. And code, I mean, it just seemed really complicated. I'd look at, like, a screen of code and be like, what? Like, that's gibberish. That's too complicated. That's not for me. No, no, no. I'm intimidated by this. But I had to get over my intimidation because I noticed a problem. Sometimes my websites wouldn't quite turn out how they had looked in Photoshop after they had gone through the coding process. Little design details would get lost in the cracks. And for good reason, too. I mean, I'm designing something in Photoshop. It's very flat. It's not interactive. And then they're turning it into code. And I'm not a coder, so I don't quite know all the things about the language. So I might be designing things that aren't quite possible when they get into development. And then you got to think about mobile devices and so on. So as a designer, being able to speak the language of code became something that I needed to be able to do, because I needed to try to solve some of these problems that were happening. And I started to speak the language of code, and it helped me out a little bit, but I needed to take it a step further, I decided, and I needed to learn code. Learning code was going to help me make this process smoother. It was going to help me save those little design details from falling through the cracks. So, starting code, I just started asking a ton of questions. I was like, what languages do I need to learn? How am I going to learn them? Can I do this at the job that I'm at? Because there's already people who do this. And should I even be doing this? Was my last question. I was feeling pushback from people. Like, a designer that wants to code, you're crazy. It's a different side of the brain. Stick with design, you'll hate it. And I sort of felt like I should just stick to design and just, I was being told that my designs weren't going to be pixel perfect in the end. Well, that made me upset, and I wasn't going to settle for that. So I was like, I'm going to learn code. So I thought about how design and development could work together, not versus each other. We all want to create the best product in the end, so how can we work together to make the best things possible? And how can I help everyone understand that design matters, even down to the pixel, the details matter? So I started learning code. And the languages of HTML and CSS quickly became my two best friends. After I started learning these languages, I was like, how come nobody told me? Like, these to me are a designer's language, and I wish I would have known that a long time ago. CSS, as a language, especially gets me really excited. It's a language that basically tells elements how they're going to be displayed on the page, sizes, colors, fonts, things that are all directly related to design. And when I got into coding, I also realized, like, it was nothing to be intimidated by. Yeah, it's hard sometimes, but also, like, totally fun. So it was great. And going from someone who just created these static designs to actually someone who coded designs was a really different change of pace for me, but it was one that I needed to do to be able to create the best websites possible. I realized that pretty quick. And I love using both sides of my brain. Not like I don't normally, but like, I get to be creative with the design, and then on the other hand, I get to be technical with the coding side, which is more black and white, like, does it work or doesn't it work, and fix it. It's a great balance. And most importantly, I became a better designer, because learning the language of code helped me create better websites, because I could design something, and while I was designing it, think about how I was going to actually code it in the next step. So it was a really great idea to change to start to learn code. So some designers still think I'm crazy for loving to code. I understand it's not for everyone, but it's a skill that's very much needed out there. In 2020, there's going to be 1.4 million jobs in a computing-related field. And to know that there's a place for people who love to design with code, it's awesome. There's tons of jobs for you out there. There's many names for people who do what I do. Front-end web developers, designers, web designers, UI designers, user experience designers, all that sort of stuff. And you could probably ask 5 different people with one of these titles what they do, and they'd say something completely different. So it just depends on where you work and how you define these roles. But really, the titles don't matter. The fact that designers can learn code matters. The fact that there's a language out there that you basically use to tell a website what to look like matters. Code's just another language. Another language that many of us are already speaking, and I think you should learn to speak it too. You won't regret it. I'm Shannon, and I design with code. Thank you.
Thank you, Shannon.
Yep.
Quick question. You had this Girls Develop It thing?
Mm-hmm.
Talk a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so Girl Develop It, this is a national organization that started in 2010, and me and my co-leader Megan started a chapter of it in Fargo in 2014, basically when we were both learning to code. We wanted a class to go to because we were just like searching the internet for how to do this. So Girl Development provides classes for women that want to learn coding. And we started the chapter in Fargo, and we've been running that for about a year and a half. It's been pretty cool. So,
talk about the culture of CoSchedule a little bit. We've got a couple CoSchedule people in here tonight.
Oh, I better be careful what I say. No, it's really great. You know, having the opportunity to be designing for an application like CoSchedule is awesome, and given the opportunity to do what I love every day with being creative and design and coding, they actually gave me the opportunity to design and code, whereas I didn't have that before. So it's been really awesome to find that spot.
So what's the next thing in Shannon's life?
Let's see. Lately I've had this crazy idea that I want to start a code school. So I don't know what's going to happen with that, but it's crazy.
It's in the cloud.
Yeah.
Could be in the cloud.
It's in the cloud somewhere.
Yeah, look in the cloud. Everybody, Shannon, thank you.
Thank you.